गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल. टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट इन कंटिन्यूएशन टू द यस्टरडेज टॉपिक. वी विल स्टार्ट विद द एनाटॉमिकल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ लंग्स और द इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन. सो यस्टरडे वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ what are the partial pressures and also we have discussed about the different types of respiration in the animal kingdom. Today we will try to understand, if you want to study any physiological structure, we have understood that we need to learn about three important things. One is the anatomy, the second one is the functionality or the physiology, the third one is the disorders of the system. Now so today we'll try to understand or try to come across the important part of respiratory organ system called as lungs. That is, as we are only completely talking about human physiology, so these seven chapters are concerned to the human physiology. So we will be talking about only about the human physiology. Now when you talk about the human respiratory system, this human respiratory system means a group of organelles which perform for the same function with a different located at different regions or different. So in this human respiratory system, we'll try to see the skull once again. So in this skull, so you can see that this part is called as the skull. On the upper part, this part is called forehead. Just below the forehead you can see the two eye sockets. And just below that you can see a cavity called as nasal cavity. This is opened just above the lips. So you can see that these are two nasal cavities or nostrils. These nostrils are internally lined with mucosal epithelium. And these nasal cavities enter into the skull and connects at the buccopharyngeal cavity. So already we have discussed in the digestive tract that it is connected to the pharynx. So if the pharynx is the junction between the nasal cavities and the molar cavity or the buccal cavity. And so that buccal cavity and the pharyngeal cavity will be present over in this particular region, approximately over here. So the pharynx will lead into a opening of the human respiratory tract called as glottis, and glottis is always covered by epiglottis, a flap like cartilaginous structure which is present, and this glottis opens into the trachea, also called as windpipe, we have discussed. So between the opening of the glottis opening into the tracheal region, we see a place where the certain type of muscles which are rapidly elongating or contracting will be present, called as vocal cords, also called as larynx. In the human beings they are called as larynx, which is generally called sound box. The sound box opens into a tube-like structure called as trachea. Trachea at the fifth location. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So at this particular fifth location, it divides into two equal halves called as primary bronchi or bronchus. The bronchus further enter into the lungs and divide into secondary bronchi. And the secondary bronchi further divide into smaller structure, tubular structures called as bronchioles. At the end of these bronchioles, the grape-like arrangement, the bunch of grape-like arrangement called as alveoli is present. This alveoli are the structural and functional units of respiration. Functional units of respiration. So whatever we are seeing, this cavity, from here to here, it is called as vertebral column. You can see here, 11 bones will be present. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Sorry, 12. 12 bones will be present, 12 rib cavities will be present, 12 plus 12, 24, and this also will be 12, this also will be 12, and the front one bone is present, which is connecting the only up to certain parts, that is 7 rib cages, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The 8th one is connected to the 7th one, not the sternum directly. So these two bones are called false ribs, and these are called as floating ribs because this will not be coming front. So here we can see that 12 bones are present, and the most important thing in the book you need to remember, where many times it was repeated, that the fifth thoracic cavity, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, at the fifth thoracic cavity the trachea is divided into two bronchi, and these bronchi enter into the lungs. The bronchi enter into the lungs. So, in the human respiratory system, the first part opening. Anatomy of human respiratory system. In the anatomy, we'll try to understand the physique, the organization, organs location of the human respiratory system. So just above the lips, two openings are there called as nasal cavities. Nasal cavities open into a bigger cavity called as buccopharyngeal cavity or pharynx. So the empty space, this is called as pharynx. Pharynx opens into the front side a cavity called glottis. So glottis is the opening of windpipe, respiratory tract. This is called, at this location we can see a structure called as vocal cords, or generally called as larynx, which is also called as sound box or voice box. Sound box or voice box, and the trachea is also called as windpipe, where the trachea will be covered partially with cartilages, C-shaped cartilages rings. The essentiality of this cartilages rings is, these cartilaginous rings are meant for preventing the lungs from collapsing. Lungs are not collapsed because of these C-shaped cartilaginous rings. And at the fifth bronchi, the thoracic cavity, or the fifth bone of the rib, they are divided into bronchi. They are also called as primary bronchi or bronchus. These further divide into the secondary in the lung called as secondary bronchi or bronchioles, bronchus. These are further divided into tertiary bronchi, where to this tertiary bronchi the grape shaped are cavities which are called the functional units, which are arranged in the bulb called as alveoli or crescent. These alveoli are the structural and units of respiration. So here the lungs, where these lungs are located, already you know, lungs are located in vertebral column in the upper thoracic cavity, and below it is lined by a membrane called as diaphragm, and on the sides with the rib cage on the sides, in front with the help of a attached bone called sternum, and on the back side spine ribs, and back side with the help of a spinal vertebrae. So this is how the location of the lungs will be present, and it is the lungs are like an airtight container. Where any changes in the atmosphere only can be reflected. Changes in atmosphere and the thoracic cavity will alter changes in lungs. But lungs will not maintain this characteristic feature. Only the vertebral column, the diaphragm, the movement of gases, and in the whatever the changes in the atmosphere will be regulated by the vertebral column, not the lungs. Lungs is located in an airtight container called as spinal vertebra or vertebral column. Vertebral column is a composition of sternum, rib cages on the lateral side, and the spinal vertebrae on the back side with the help of spinal vertebrae. So now try to draw the diagram of human lung. Here, yes, once again we'll discuss, but in order to understand these terms, first we have gone through a oral view. Yes, any doubts? Okay, whatever the doubts, maybe will be clarified later, but start drawing the diagram along with me. Also, I recorded class. Please make a note that this is also a recorded class. Easily. So you can use this format, and if you are able to draw the diagram as of your own, you can do whatever you want. The diagram should be, this is a most important diagram for 5 marks including the explanation, or else 3 marks diagram, sometimes 5 also. Outer shape is most important, and one more thing you need to take into consideration is every time while you are writing the labeling, it should be on the diagram should be on the left side, the written part should be on the left side, right side, and it should not cross the line, what you are drawing should not cross each other line. So this is the most important thing you need to remember for your diagrammatic point of view representation. Thank you. Discussions, Nana. I said you many things. You are knowing that this is a recorded class. That is the reason we generally don't take recorded class here. But as per your need, we are coming here only for this particular reason. Still, you are unable to cooperate. We cannot. Only online classes will be there for you. Right lobe will be divided into two lobes with an oblique fissure, and left lung will be divided into three different lobes. So whichever you feel, either textbook or this one is easy, that one you can drop. More discussion, please. Chalks, I am only drawing with two different colors, no need to draw with two different colors. so it can fill completely. It's primary bronchus, bronchi or bronchus. So here, okay, so in the human respiratory system, our human respiratory system consists of certain parts in the anatomical setup. The anatomical setup, just above the lips, a pair of nostrils are present. So these nostrils will open into a two passages called as nasal cavities. These nasal cavities open into internal of the skull called as internal nares. Internal nares open into buccal cavity and pharyngeal cavity called as buccopharyngeal cavity. Between the pharynx, already you know that it is a junction of the digestive tract and respiratory tract. The pharynx opens into glottis. Glottis is an opening of respiratory tract. The glottis will be covered by a flap called epiglottis. This glottis opens into a muscular structure called as larynx, generally called as voice box or sound box, because sounds are produced from this itself. This larynx opens into trachea. Now the trachea opens into or segregates into two bronchi. So two primary bronchi primary bronchi. This each primary bronchi when enters into the lungs, airtight cavity called lungs, and divides into secondary bronchi. This secondary bronchi further divides into more than branch structures called as tertiary bronchi. To this tertiary bronchi, the structure and functional unit of respiration called alveoli are attached. These alveoli are the branch-like structures. When you look onto this alveoli will be mostly looking like a bunch of grape-like structures where more number of alveoli are attached to this at different locations, and these are the saccular structures present towards the So that are the structure and functional units, and this lungs are covered by a membrane called pleura. So the inner pleura or visceral pleura will be in contact with the lungs. The inner visceral pleura or inner pleura will be in contact, will be facing towards the lungs. And outer pleura is facing towards the vertebral column. Outer pleura will be facing towards the... So the two membrane structure, it is closed. Each lung is enclosed in a two membrane structure called as pleura. So inner one is facing towards the lung and outer pleura is towards the vertebral column. And between the inner pleura and outer pleura, a fluid called pleural fluid is present. This pleural fluid is protecting the lungs from our external shocks, or also it also maintains the nourishment to the cells on the surroundings of the lungs, as well as it also protects from electrical shocks. It also protects the body from the electrical shocks. And generally, when you talk about that, air enters from the passage. Air enters from the upper passage, and air also moves from the similarly in the backward direction from the same cavity, from the same passage. So this is how the movement of air takes place in and out, and the carbon dioxide or oxygen is moved in and out in the following process. So between the two lungs, a heart is present, which is the essential part of the transport system or circulatory system called heart is located, and heart is also protected by externally by lungs as well as the vertebral column. So generally in this lungs we can see that more than several million number of alveoli are present. These alveoli will be participating in the exchange of gases, where from the nostrils to alveoli, whatever the part is going on is called as conduction, and from there, from the alveoli to the tissues to the blood to the again tissues, this part is called as exchange part. For that reason only we have discussed that the topic name is breathing and exchange of gases, because so conduction will be taking place, respiration will be taking place, that is exchange of gases will take place in the lungs. So this complete anatomical setup is an airtight container where this is contained in a vertebral column, on the other side supported by the rib cage cavity, front by sternum and the back by spinal vertebra. And below, in the below cavity, it is supported by the membrane called as diaphragm. So this diaphragm is responsible, also helpful in the process of respiration. Any doubts?